Hi everyone, it's been a while since I've done a jigsaw. Here we go. I've been away. I went on a vacation. I think I mentioned that. And just so you know, my mic is in a different position today. It's closer to the mouse because I thought maybe people would like to hear the clicking a little bit more. Let's do an arrange. There we go. So let me know if you like hearing the clicks better, if it actually made a difference. I don't even know yet. Just making some changes. Let's see what happens. And so I was out of town. I was in Portland, visiting some lovely people, and it was great. It was really great. I really like traveling, so it was nice to get out of town. Interesting being in America. Not like obviously I'm obviously familiar with America. Being a Canadian, it's something very similar cultures. And then just interesting to see some differences. And so I got back yesterday. And I was more tired than I thought. I had some plans for today. And honestly, they've all kind of just fallen through because I'm just too tired. I got up, I got dressed. I was supposed to have a voice lesson, and that didn't happen. Yeah, I'm more tired than I thought. It can wait a week. They're just for fun. And so, postponed that. Luckily, I'd already gotten dressed, or I don't think I would have gotten dressed. And then, yeah, I had some lunch. And then I had a little bit of a nap while listening to some of my favorite ASMR people. That was great. Had a session with a client. And yeah, so I'm just taking a really easy day. Sometimes that's hard for us to do, I think, when there's that logical, sort of more that cold logical side that's like, well, it's not like you did a lot. Like some of the thoughts I was having, it's like, well, you just traveled. It's not like you walked the whole way home or at all. So it shouldn't be that tiring. And yet, this is what we know. The reality is traveling is very stressful. Even if ostensibly all we're doing is sitting in a plane, it can still be tricky. So yeah, just taking it easy today. And I thought, what a perfect day to do a new puzzle. And so, combining some of my favorite things, I've got the rainbow as well as doing some craft pictures. So this is, I think it looks crocheted to me. I don't know much about crochet. I'm just gonna do an arrange. Hopefully that'll make things a bit easier. Looks like crochet to me, not so much a knit. And it's got the rainbow, so that's always nice. So I think in my last video, oh, where does this one go? Don't know yet. I think in my last video, I talked about the first cat that we had. Her name was Kathy. And so I thought this time I would talk about our second cat named Reggie. And his full name was Reginald. My mom named him. She wanted to give him a regal name. He was this little tiny orange tabby. And we had him. I can remember us getting him, I think, and I think I was about three. So we had him at the same time that we had Kathy. I don't think she was particularly impressed by him. He was a very loving cat. So he was a very typical orange and white male tabby. Very sweet. Kind of dumb as a post, but just such a lovely, good kitty. I don't know why. I was so young, I don't know why we got him when he was quite young. I think he was just 8 weeks. And I think he might have been the runt or something. He was a little bit neurotic, I guess is the word we used to describe him. In that he over-groomed. He would lick all his fur off. And he would often eat his food until he threw up. He just didn't have a lot of, like, the language I would use. He didn't have a lot of self-regulation. And I remember us just sort of being baffled by him when we were younger. And I don't remember how long he lived. I think until he was about six. And he was, and I was so young, I would have been about eight. I don't remember what was wrong with him. But it ended up with the vet just saying the best thing would be to put him to sleep. I wasn't quite sure what illnesses he had, being so young. But he was a very sweet, very loving cat. In some ways very different than Kathy, who was always there for us when we were sick, just absolutely loyal. But Reggie was the kind of cat who was there for, you know, it didn't really matter. You could be sick, you could be fine. Very much like a dog in some ways. The biggest tell, the difference between them, is when we would take them to the vet. So let's remember, this would have been in like 1979, 1980, so a long time ago. When we took them to the vet, we of course didn't have carriers. Here, let's do another arrange here. There we go. I bet we can get all this purple done. We didn't have carriers, so they were just in the car. You know, whether or not we even had seatbelts, I don't even know. So they were just in the car with us. And Kathy would hide under the seats in a very common cat way and just sort of meow, feel like forlornly, and meow, just making those very specific cat sounds we all know when they're upset. And Reggie, bless his little funny heart, would sit on my dad's lap while he was driving and put his paws on the steering wheel and watch. He would just watch the driving, super calm, very casual, and just watch the world go by from my dad's lap while being driven to the vet. And I think that's a perfect way to describe this, the very different personalities between those two. Yeah, so that's the story of Reggie. I don't have a lot of memories of him. I just remember him being a very sweet cat. I can remember being able to trudge around with him in my little arms and him just sort of flopping and being totally okay with it. Very lovely cat. And I remember him drooling. I remember him drooling a lot as well. I think he would sleep with us too, like he would sleep on our beds. Oh, maybe let's finish off the top here. I always find that so satisfying if we can actually finish all the pieces here. I think we're quite close. Oh, we'll get that done too. There we go. Now just a little bit more. Two more pieces. And that last piece, there you are. Okay. I find just the methodical way of working with the colors, that's the most peaceful for me, is working with the rainbows. I know a lot of people like the more complex ones where there's like lots of sky and lots of places, and I honestly really don't look to these kinds of puzzles to be challenged. I really just do them to be soothed. And so, just these last bits. of the darker blue leading to the baby blue. So while I was in Portland, I also went to Powell's Books, and I went there 3 times. And I only bought things 2 out of the 3 times, which I thought was a great indicator of self-control. I don't have a lot of self-control in bookstores. I have a lot of books that I haven't read, though. They're just sitting on the shelves patiently. I think I should read those before I buy more books. And then I buy more books. And so I bought quite a few books. That was very satisfying. And I bought some other things. I bought some clothes. But I'm quite impressed with myself. I stopped myself. There was a store, I think it was called Wild Fang. I think that's the name. I could be totally wrong, though. And that store had a set of enamel pins that, so there's a set of 4 of the Golden Girls. And I didn't buy them. I was really, really tempted to. But they were $12 each, so that would have been $48 altogether. With the exchange rate, I was just like, oh, I don't know. I don't know if I can. Where do you go? I don't know where that one goes. Like, I don't know if I can. If I can manage that. That might be just a little bit too steep. Too steep for me. And so I passed. I passed them by. And that was a pretty impressive show of restraint. As well as the same store. I didn't buy the big long like candles that often have saints and the Virgin Mary on. I don't know what they're called. I apologize. I'm sure there's a very specific name for them. I don't know it. Apologize for that. But there was one that was of Dana and Mulder from the X-Files, and I really also wanted that. But it was $18, and I was thinking, oh, like the chance of it breaking, getting it back. So I passed that by, and I really love the X-Files. I didn't like it when it was on the air when I was younger. I liked it after watching it on Netflix. And whenever I think about the X-Files, I think about the Greek 100 course I took in my first year of university. I studied ancient Greek. And I guess the Greek, so in Canada we don't have any kind of fraternity, so when I say like the Greek like community there, I do mean like Greek and Roman studies. I had a t-shirt, and it was of the X-Files, but of course it was called the Chi Files, and Chi is the letter X in ancient Greek, and then above it said Exohealethia, so that means the truth is out there, and it means it in ancient Greek. I'll say it one more time, it's one of the loveliest things to say, Exohealethia. And it means the truth is out there. Here's our last piece. And we're done. Exohealethia.